In this session, I'm going to talk about standard journal entries, as Business Central refers to them. Some people could refer to them as recurring journals, or at least this is one method to consider for recurring journals. So let's take a look. Within Business Central, I'm going to go to the Finance menu, drop down, and go to General Journals. I have a list of batches. I'm going to go to My Batch. And you'll see I took the liberty to already create a journal entry that is typically something that I would do on a bi-weekly basis, maybe weekly basis, whatever type of journal entries you do a number of times. Okay, and this could be weekly, bi-weekly, monthly, however often you want. So here it just again took the liberty of creating journal entries. I could have as many journal entries within this batch as I like to, but in this case, I'm keeping it simple and have one journal entry. Now, I mainly created all of these lines. If this is something that I do on a weekly basis or bi-weekly basis, as I mentioned, or monthly basis, and I don't want to continually retype this entry in over and over and over every time. So there's a feature in here. If I go to Actions, Functions, Save as Standard Journal, what this will do is it will actually save this journal entry and allow me to bring it back in the next time rather than have to mainly type in the six lines in this case, in this example, every single time. So I'm going to click on Save Standard Journal. I'm going to give it a code, which I'm just going to call it Payroll. And here you see I could either save the amounts or not. It's right now it's triggered as no. That means if once I post the journal entry, it's gonna zero out and it's gonna bring zeros back in. Or I could tell it to yes, save the amounts because I'm salary based, if you will. Nobody is hourly, so the numbers are always the same. So in my example, of course, right? The option is whether turn it on, which is this is on, or turn it off to save the amounts. I'm going to turn that off. Or I could turn it on and then override the amounts. Okay, let's turn it on. Okay, so what it just did is it actually saved it. It did nothing more than save it, but it did nothing for the actual journal entry itself. So now that I saved that batch, now keep in mind, once I post it, if I post this batch is going to disappear. So if I don't save it, before posting, then you have to start all over and enter that journal entry. Okay, but because I saved it before posting, now I have the ability to come back to it. So it's going to go to the post, yes, successful. Now those journal entries are gone, right? So I'm going to escape all the way out. I'm going to go back in. Let's just say it's a week later, 2 weeks later, right? Go back to my batch. There's nothing in here. Now I'm going to go to Process, Get Standard Journals, and now you'll see I have a payroll journal that I could use. And I could save as many journal entries as I like to. You're not limited to any type of saving of journal entries. You get as many as you want. So in theory, I only have one right here called Payroll, but I could have as many different saved journal entries as I'd like. So I'm going to click OK. And lo and behold, it brought everything back in so I don't have to retype it. One thing to note, so when you bring it back in, it brought it back in on your date that you brought it back in. So today's work date was 10/26, so it brought it back in as of the work date of 10/26 with all the dollar amounts. Now, if for some reason the dollar amounts change, then you could simply override these amounts if needed. But because I said to save the amounts, it brought in those amounts. So I can either save the amounts, override them if I want to, or have them just come in as all zeros and I type them in all over again. But the bulk of the work is done for you because all the lines, in this case, the six lines, automatically came in. I don't have to retype them. And now I could just go, if everything is good, I could go back in and just post my next batch. So you see how much time that actually saves you. Thanks for watching. If we can further assist you, please reach out to us at epcgroup.net.